But what about the price? Oh, oh, my sister, you should think twice. Oh,
this is the Landmark Church of Holiness Through Christ Outreach Ministries, located at 1523 West Washington Street in South Bend, Indiana. The pastor is Bishop Thomas H. Willis, Jr., and our overseer is Apostle Paul Grant. We would like to invite you to watch us every Sunday afternoon on Facebook Live at 1:30 p.m. on the page of Bishop Thomas H. Willis, Jr., and to listen to our evening service every Sunday on WUBS 89.7 FM in South Bend, Indiana, at 6:30 p.m. to 7 o'clock p.m. We also have a Sunday school conference call every Saturday evening at 7 o'clock p.m. Central Standard Time and at 8 o'clock p.m. Eastern Standard Time, taught by Evangelist Beverly Willis. The telephone number is 605-313-2142, and the access code is 388-999-POUND. If you're not able to tune in, you can listen to the playback number, which is 605-313-5153, with the same access code. If your carrier charged for this line, please hang up and dial 716-293-9720, then dial the number and the access code. We are so happy to be able to share what God has put in our heart and our mind, that you may be able to be blessed of God and strengthened in holiness. Yeah. Now we have prayer offered up by Minister Marvin Frazier.
Amen.
Yes, yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
God bless you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord, oh God.
Bishop Willis.
God bless you, sir.
To Evangelist
God
Willis,
bless you, sir.
To Minister Tony and to all the saints here.
God bless you.
Let's thank God for being here. Bear with me as I sing this song. I don't know all of it, but it just came to my mind to sing it.
All right.
He's sweet, I know. He's sweet, I know. Dark clouds may rise and storm winds may blow, but I I know.
Yes.
Yes.
He's sweet. I know. He's sweet. I know. Dark clouds may rise and storm winds may blow, but I'll tell the world wherever I go that I found a Savior. Oh, and he's sweet, I know.
Bishop Thomas H. Willis. Amen. Let's say amen for him as he comes.
Amen.
I'm enjoying Jesus. How about you? I'm enjoying Jesus. How about you?
Amen. One more time.
being in the house of God. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord.
Amen.
You can't be in a better place.
Yes. Come on.
By being in the house of the Lord.
Right.
You know, so many people get excited about going to the taverns and going to the show and going here and going there. When they come down to church, they get bored. The church. My goodness. What y'all do in church? Praise God.
Right.
Okay. Glorifying God.
Yeah.
And living right. Brought us too far by faith for us to turn our backs on him.
Oh,
do you hear what I'm saying?
Yes.
Ain't nothing in this world worth going to hell
nothing.
To the lake of fire for nothing.
Amen.
Am I right about it?
Yes.
Nothing.
Amen.
Life itself itself is not good enough for me to go to hell for.
Amen.
But I still got something for today, part three. Amen. God even told me to change, so I'm going to change. I'm still talking about what?
Holiness
has not changed.
Amen.
Am I right about it, y'all?
Yes, sir.
Amen. As I always say, amen. People change.
Right.
But God didn't change.
Right.
He's the same today, yesterday, and forevermore. And the scripture says he changes what?
Not.
Amen.
But people have been given to change.
Yes.
And I got this from God, too. It says, holiness still works.
Amen. Amen.
Can y'all repeat that after me?
Holiness
still
works.
It works for me.
Amen.
This is a personal thing.
Come on now.
And sanctification still works.
Amen.
Look, God didn't get rid of it. He didn't tell us, you know what, you ain't got to live holy no more. You ain't got to be sanctified. You ain't got to be set apart from the world. You know, my bag, I'm just, and so now you can change it. No, God ain't changing nothing. God ain't changing nothing when it comes down to his word.
Right.
Am I right about it?
Right.
Since the beginning, God's law stood.
Yes.
From the time he told Adam and Eve, touch not that tree of good and evil.
Amen.
If you do, you're going to die. That was a commandment.
Amen.
That was a law that they were supposed to obey.
Amen.
Since that time on up, God was giving out laws for people, for his people to do and live by.
Right.
When they didn't live by it, what did he do? He punished them.
Yes, sir.
God still wants us to be holy,
yes.
Sanctified,
yes.
Undefiled,
all right,
before God.
Amen.
Now, if you got a problem with me talking about holiness, amen, just stay on the line.
All right.
Amen. I ain't going to tell you to get off the line, stay on the line, because you need to know.
Yes.
His holiness or hell.
That's right.
Come on now. You ain't just going to heaven anyway because you know, well, I know this preacher. That preacher ain't can't put you in heaven.
Amen.
I know this missionary. See, that missionary can't put you in heaven.
No.
It's the life that you live.
Right.
This is an individual thing.
Yes,
God's still telling us to live holy. He's still saying, be ye holy, for I, the Lord God, is what? Holy.
That's
his word. He's standing on his word. Heaven and earth shall pass away before anything be taken away from what God's word said.
Yes.
Ain't that what the scripture say?
Amen.
Before God take down, heaven and earth gonna pass away first.
Come on,
but God is not gonna take down for nobody. That's the way we gotta be as preachers.
Amen.
And missionaries and teachers. And even if you're not a missionary or teacher, you still gotta stand on holiness.
Yes, right.
Stand on what you believe. I don't care what nobody says. I don't care what anybody say on your job, in your home. You stay saved.
That's
yes.
right.
You stay holy.
Yes.
You stay sanctified.
Yes.
Save yourself from this untoward generation.
Amen.
And unsave yourself means sometimes you have to separate yourself. Can't be hanging around the same folks that you know is lying, stealing, and cheating, and running around, and chasing the girls, and you sitting up there laughing and giggling. It ain't funny.
No.
You ought to be living the life. You ought to be living the life before them.
Amen.
Don't be ashamed, because the Bible says if you be ashamed of God, God will be ashamed of you.
Right.
When he come back with his holy angel.
Yeah,
let him know. Yeah, I'm saved.
Come on, man.
I'm sanctified. I'm holy.
Yeah.
What about you?
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen. Because sometimes people try to talk you out of holiness. And sometimes people do talk folks out of holiness.
Amen.
Making them feel ashamed of who they are.
Right.
Amen. I am who I am by the
the grace of God. That's I'm not ashamed to say that I'm sanctified, that I'm holy. Amen. And I'm standing on righteousness.
Yeah.
Do you hear what I'm saying? I'm standing on righteousness.
Yeah.
Do you hear what I'm saying? My mother got to know that I'm saved.
Amen.
Your daddy got to know you saved. Yeah. Your Uncle John got to know you saved. Come on now. Your Auntie Louisa got to know that you saved.
Right.
Y'all better come on with me now. Well, that's my Auntie Louisa, yo. She going to snap. Let her snap. Let her snap. Hey, you know what? I'm sorry that you don't like it, but I'm holy, baby.
Yeah.
Auntie, I'm holy. I'm sanctified. I can't go get your snuff.
Right. Okay.
You can't be partakers of somebody going to get their cigarette.
That's
right. They reefer.
Amen.
Now all my whole things are passed away.
Yeah.
And behold, all things have become new. They start lighting up, you start running out, going different ways. Don't wait till they tell you, brother, you know what, you might as well go. You might as well leave. You ain't got to tell me I'm gone now.
Right.
I'm still talking about holiness.
Yes.
Sanctified. Undefiled. You stand away from all that stuff.
Right.
I don't know where I'm going there, but I'm going there.
Right. Right.
Hey, man, you know they drinking and carrying on and out the food and the stuff and talking silly?
Yes.
What you sitting there for?
Come on.
Get up from there. And if you come to my house, bro, you're going to act like you sanctified.
Yep. I know that's right.
Did you hear what I said?
Yes, sir.
You come to my house, you put your big hand and leave it out there in the car.
Yes, right.
Leave your cigarettes out there in the car. You know, sometimes your own kin folks will hate you because you saved.
Oh,
you're
right,
because
you sanctified.
Because you sanctified. What do you care?
Right.
Take a stand.
Yes.
Let them know, brothers, don't be hating the brothers. Don't be get like me.
Right.
Stop going around it.
Amen.
And you got in their weave, you sit up there saying, help me, Jesus. Get out of here.
Right. Amen. Get out of there.
Come on now.
Get away from that.
He gave you a mind to know, how to get out of there yourself.
Yes, that's right.
Yes.
Amen.
I hear what I hear.
Right.
Do you hear what I hear? I hear what I hear.
Go ahead.
And ain't nobody told me nothing but God. Like
right.
How you gonna win your sister over when you acting like that?
Yes.
How you gonna win your uncle over when you acting like this?
Right.
And they hear you cussing.
Right.
Swearing.
Come on. Oh, that I mean.
Doing all right now.
It's the Holy Ghost.
It hey. Right. I tell you like it is. You gotta be holy. See, this is a holy church.
Yes. Right.
This is a righteous church.
Yes, sir.
We are a few, but we are a mighty few.
Yes.
We are a mighty few.
Yes.
Straighten up, because I'll give you some more. They go. They're trying to straighten up. Y'all been there.
Amen. Yeah. Amen. Yep.
Keep on now. I'll give you some more. Sometimes you have to act like you smiling. But you hurt me.
Yep.
Come on now.
Amen.
Hey! It's a joy to be saved.
Yes.
Do you hear what I'm saying?
Oh, yes.
Don't knock it. Don't knock it till you try it.
Yes.
God ain't against that. If you're going to be sincere,
right.
I've seen people go to church because they wanted to try it out. They ended up staying in the church, in a holy church.
Amen.
You hear what I'm saying? And some people say, I ain't never felt like this in my life.
That's right.
Out of all the times I was in the world, I feel so good and so peaceful.
Yes.
They didn't have to snort and all that sort of stuff. Come on, man. You ain't got to... Putting that stuff all up your nose.
Right.
You killing yourself.
Yeah, right.
Why am I going this way?
Right.
Just
the Lord knows.
All your inside of your nose is all burnt out and whatnot.
Right.
Come on now. Eyes just as red as fire.
Yep.
Do you hear what I'm saying? Amen. But God, when he said it, he take away all that.
Yeah.
Hey. Yeah. He take away that. You know, Give me a teaspoon, bro. Oh, y'all didn't think I knew that, did y'all?
Yeah,
come on.
Just give me a teaspoon.
Come on.
Face all screwed up.
Yep.
Next thing you know, they dead.
Right.
Because
right.
They overdosed.
Right. Uh-huh.
You fool! You got a foolish death!
Yes.
Yes.
So
true.
Amen.
And you know how it is. This flesh don't never get tired. Amen. Because it's trying to go to a higher level. Why am I going this way? Trying to go to a higher level. You hear what I'm saying? You know, when you first got started in something, you was beginning, you know, you was clean.
Right.
You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But then after a while, you know, you got, oh man, I got, that's why some people have an overdose.
Right.
Because the first one don't make it.
Right.
Now I got to do the second one.
Yeah.
And the third one. And the fourth one. And the next one, man, did you hear? So-and-so just died of an overdose. That was because they were trying to get over and beyond where they were supposed to go.
Right.
And the devil taking all that there. Now you want to go to where no man has ever gone before. And you're right, you did. Hell. And I ain't trying to make no fun telling that, but it's real. You are going to where you've never gone before. And that's the lake of fire. Hell. You need to know that. I don't care if you don't believe in hell, there is a hell.
Yes,
y'all heard me say a couple of weeks ago, you tell people to go to hell, but you don't, why are you telling them to go to hell if you don't believe in hell?
Right.
Tell them in a minute, go to hell.
Uh-huh.
But then when we talk about hell,
come on.
Hell, nobody believe in hell.
Come on.
You did, you said, told somebody to go to hell.
Right.
And hell also represents what? Brain. And that's a curse when you tell somebody to go to hell.
Yes, right.
You cursing them.
Yes.
And the Bible told us to bless and curse what? Nah.
Right.
I'm going wherever God wants me to go. I'm going. Holiness still works.
Yes.
Come on now. I ain't taking down. I don't care if everybody leave us. Y'all hear what I'm saying? If everybody leave us and we by ourselves,
right.
They don't hold me down. Don't let nobody next door tell you.
Right.
In our church, we don't do all this. And in our church, that's the problem. That's your church.
Right.
But Jesus said, above this rock, I'll build my church.
Yeah.
persevering.
Yes.
Keep on trucking, man. I got to get where God wants me to be.
Yes.
God don't want you out there. Well, he didn't make you to sin.
Come to Jesus.
He didn't make you to sin.
No.
Amen.
God, when he formed you in the dust of the earth, he didn't make you to sin.
Right.
He made man holy.
Yes.
Right. Excuse me. He made him holy.
Yes.
He didn't have to sanctify him. He was already holy.
Amen.
He had a mindset of God, holy. But the devil, see, the devil came along.
Yes.
And the devil tempted him.
Yes.
See, you got folk that'll tempt you.
Yeah.
Who gonna know, man? Come on, man. Come on, man. Come on. Come on, girl. Come on. Who gonna know? It's just me and you, baby. Just me and you. That's all. Come on, help the brother up. Come on. Come on, see. Because I've been looking at you for a long time, sweetie. You know. And these guys, they kill me when they be talking about the side, didn't they?
Yep.
And he wasn't even falling for that stuff. And he done just got through telling somebody they had to block out.
Right, okay. Have no labels. Okay.
Telling the girls the same thing.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
And they all fall in love.
Right, right. Come on.
With somebody don't even really care about you. All he want to do is get some.
That's
it. Amen.
Oh, that's it. Say what you want out there in the world.
Right.
Say what I want in the
world.
You doing it, so I'm talking about it.
Right.
If you hit me, say ouch.
Right.
Next time my preacher's gonna say ouch. Amen. Don't do it. You won't have to say ouch.
Right.
You won't have to get mad.
Right.
You won't have to get upset.
Yes.
Come on, right, y'all.
Yes,
declare. And like, as I also said, I told you, I woke up, God is still talking to me about holiness. Holiness.
Yes, yes.
Holiness. This church is going to be holy.
Yes,
now, after I leave here, I don't know what it's going to be. I don't have no control. I done did my part.
All right.
So it's up to the next pastor.
Yes, right.
He's got to give an account to God.
Amen.
As long as I still got the activities in my limbs and blood still going on, I'm going to say it's holiness. I'll give you something to make get mad for. That's what your mama used to tell you.
Yeah.
People were scared. Some people were more scared of their parents than they are God.
Okay.
And God is the one who can do more damage.
Right.
Than your parents.
Yes.
See? Now your parents can take you out of here. But that's all they can do.
That's it.
But God can suffer you to die and then turn around and put you, bring you back to life. And then send you hell.
Right.
Yes.
Oh, y'all didn't believe that, did
Amen.
I know y'all do, but I'm saying, you know, you can die, and when the time for you to come back, you will come back up out of the grave. Because the Bible said the dead in Christ is going to rise.
Amen.
And then when we die, we're going to come back. And we ain't going to come back as Auntie so-and-so. We're going to come back looking the way we are now, holy, but we're going to have on a glorious body.
Yes.
Y'all better hear me. That's kind of deep. I don't want to touch you.
It's
in the book. It's in
the book.
Yes, sir.
And then those that remain, those that, amen, that didn't want God, those that died without God, he's going to bring them back too.
Yes. Amen.
He's going to bring them back to die eternally.
Yes.
Forever and ever. And the Bible said there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth.
Right.
Go to Revelation 21.
Yes.
No getting out.
Amen.
Because you know you got people that are saying when you're dead, you're done. Don't believe that. Don't believe that lie.
The
Bible talks about it. Well, you know how I said, you know, people say, who believe that Bible? We do.
Amen.
So we see what's in there is true and real.
Oh, yes.
And we see things that have been prophesied years ago coming to pass right now.
Yes.
And it's saying men are waxing worse and worse. Yes. Are they getting worse?
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Yes. You're right.
Yes,
come on now.
Amen.
Things are happening.
Yes.
And it's going to get worse than that.
Yes.
But say, Nina! Young to be saved.
Amen.
Come on.
Amen.
Come on now.
Amen.
Jesus at 12 years old was sitting in the temple.
Yes.
Right.
Getting wisdom.
Yes.
From those. Amen.
Amen.
That taught him the law.
Amen.
Y'all can hear me now.
Amen.
12 years old. You can go before in church 9 years old.
Yeah.
I told you last week, 2 weeks ago, you know, you got some children that are fornicating at 9 years old.
Amen.
Having sex.
Yes. Right, sir.
Amen. Yes.
And it might be the son of you.
Terrible thing.
You didn't hear that when we were coming up.
Come on.
I said you didn't hear it. I didn't say they didn't do it. You didn't hear it.
Right. Mm-hmm.
But now it's become a thing. You know, 9 years old, she's pregnant. 10 years old, she's pregnant.
Mm-hmm. My God.
Amen.
12 years old, she's pregnant. I don't care if you're 20 years old and you're pregnant. If it wasn't marriage in it, you're still wrong.
Yeah.
Wrong.
Yeah.
Wrong.
Yeah.
Yeah. And they got the nerve to celebrate. Let's celebrate, girl, because this is a happy occasion. Oh, no, it's not a happy occasion because you did it in sin.
Right.
Amen.
Right.
You got the baby in sin.
Right.
Through fornication.
Right. Amen.
Celebrate
Amen.
That.
I ain't celebrating that.
Come on.
Oh, y'all better come on now.
Amen.
But once God save you and wash you, he forget all that.
Yes.
All your sins will not be remembered towards you. You ask God to save you right now.
That's
all the stuff you did from yesterday back, God will not hold it against you.
Yes, you do.
Thank God for His mercy.
Yes,
thank God for His mercy. You can tell me God will forget all of this.
Yes.
But see, sometimes people won't let you stop remembering.
Right.
Amen.
But God won't bring it back to your remembrance.
Amen.
The devil will.
Right.
Now he'll say, man, you know what? I remember you used to do this and you used to do that. That's the devil bringing it back to you.
Right.
Not God.
Right.
But God ain't going to hold it against you. All your sins will be taken away. Taken away. Taken away. He will not remember it against you no more. He will not hold it. I don't care, amen, if you were the murderer. If you ask God to save you, he will save you. And he will forgive you. Sometimes you still got to serve your sentence.
Amen.
There are some people that God took them out of there.
Yes.
Amen.
But there are some still had to serve their sentence.
That's right.
They are serving their what? Sentence.
Yes, sir.
But they still say.
But they say.
And they talking to the brothers in jail.
Amen. Yeah.
Do you hear what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Man, I was like you. I used to do that. And I was murdering. What not?
Yes.
So. But God saved me.
Yes.
God will not hold it against you. He won't throw it in your face.
Right.
God will not throw it in your face.
Yeah.
Shame on us if we throw people's sins back
Come
in
on,
your face.
Right.
Shame on you. Amen. I don't care what you used to do. What you doing now?
Right.
What you doing now? That's forgiveness. If God had to forgive you, you got to forgive somebody else.
Right. Amen.
I don't care if he took all your money, left you broke. He got saved, you got to forgive him.
That's right.
That's right.
That's right.
Now, bro, you know, since you say, you know that $50 you stole from me. I need that back.
Amen.
Where's forgiveness?
Amen.
Oh, that's hard now.
Amen.
You're going to throw it in your brother's face.
Right.
By the way, you know, since you say now,
oh, no.
You do owe me $50. Let the brother alone. Let him breathe.
Right.
It's quiet, all of it. It's quiet off. I'm getting my money because
see?
God know where your heart is.
Right,
where is that love?
Right, man. Amen.
Trying to get that money out of his pocket. I know. Y'all help me, Jesus. God help me.
Oh,
it sounds funny, but it's real.
Amen.
You don't do that.
Right. No, right.
Come on now. Your heavenly Father had to forgive you.
That's right. Come on.
Come on now. He ain't gonna remember. He said he threw it in the sea.
Right.
Never to remember your sins no more.
Yes, right.
No more. That means he gonna throw it up in your face.
Thank
you. I remember when. You know that's torture.
Yes, it is.
Oh, you know that's torture, throwing stuff up in people's faces.
Yes,
they used to do.
Yes.
I don't care if they didn't even get saved. If they stop doing it and want to do right,
amen.
Don't keep throwing it up in their face.
Amen.
You're going to reap what you sow.
That's right.
Amen.
How did I get on that?
That's right.
Amen.
It's still holding it, man.
Yes,
it is. Oh, yeah.
Without which no man should see the Lord.
Yes, that's amen.
I ain't holding nothing in my heart against nobody.
Amen.
Do you hear what I'm saying?
Yes.
I got to make it. I got to make it. I got to make it. No man. And that's a book. Amen. I said last week, sometimes, you know, people say, well, God, you know, God don't expect us to live holy like that no more. Where did you see that? Amen. What Bible did you read that
right.
in?
Right, right.
Amen. Oh, I know that's your family Bible that you read it out of. Because it sure was not God's Bible.
Right. Right.
You know, we got a family Bible. That's the problem. We got a family Bible. You ought to have a Bible that came from holy men that were led by God.
Right. Amen. Amen.
Am I right about it?
Amen.
Yes. Amen. God will turn you to where you need to go.
Yes.
To know about him. You want to know everything about God? Read your Bible. Read your Bible, and then get under a preacher that's going to teach you.
Yes.
You can't go to any preacher.
No.
Some preachers will tell you, I sinned, and he's already told you, I sinned, you sinned, and everybody sinned. When he said, I sinned, get out of there.
Amen.
I don't want somebody that's sinning just like I am. He's just as bad as I am.
Come on.
He's doing what I'm doing, and sometimes works.
Yes.
And I'm going to stay there.
No.
Because you know, rev be red back, man. Lord, you'll make a way. And if you just hold on, can't make it. See, that's all they want to hear.
Right.
But tell them about their sin.
Right.
They got to hear reverence.
Right.
Because reverence is the tip of their fancy.
Right.
Make them feel good.
Yes.
But when reverence changes, he'll tell you it's holiness.
Right.
And God said, holy and reverend is his name.
Yes. Yes.
Who told you to take on reverend? Come on now. The world did that.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
He gave the titles.
Yep.
Yes, sir.
Some prophets.
Yes.
Yes.
Some evangelists.
Yes.
Some what?
Apostles.
Amen. That's the word.
Different ones. He called to the ministry for the edifying of the church.
Yes. Amen.
For the edifying of the church. So you might benefit by it.
Yeah.
That's why we preach. Yeah, that preacher, he just preached too hard for me. That's God preaching to you. That is God talking to you. Man, that preacher there. Woo! Man, he's something else.
Amen.
Oh, you should have saw me before I got saved. I was something else. All of us were something else.
Right.
But don't tell nobody. Keep it to yourself.
Amen.
Some things you just can't testify.
Right.
Yeah.
Amen.
I do not encourage you to get up and say, you know what, saints? I was a whore.
No.
Leave that to yourself.
Right. Amen.
Right.
That's right.
Don't put your business out in the
right.
street.
Amen. Amen.
Your family knows some other people look, leave it there.
Right.
Amen.
Oh, y'all better hear me now. Some things you just can't tell.
Amen.
Hey.
Right.
Now, is that all right?
Yes, sir. Amen.
I'm still talking about holiness.
Yes.
And sanctification. Well, you know I'm holy. That's a hold on to.
Amen.
Hold on to holiness. Because the devil's going to try you.
Amen. Yes. Right.
He's going about as a roaring lion.
Come on.
Seeking who he may divide. The devil don't care about you being holy.
No, he don't.
He don't care about you being sanctified. He wants you to get you back out there under him.
Right.
Where he can control you.
Yeah.
You know they used to have a saying a long time ago that said the devil made me do it.
Uh-huh.
And they even had a t-shirt.
Right.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, they had a t-shirt and was glorying in it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it was like, the devil made me do it. They'd be laughing. That wasn't funny.
No.
Right.
No.
Right.
You don't know how real that is.
Right.
Yeah, the devil moved on your mind and on your spirit.
Amen.
But you know what? You can't even blame it on the devil. Uh-oh, it's quiet.
Amen. Amen.
When you stand before God, you can't say the devil made me do it.
No, you cannot.
Because you ain't got to yield to that devil.
That's right.
Right.
Amen.
Right.
Amen.
That's why God set up another way.
Yes.
That's why he set up holiness.
Yes.
That's why he sent his son so we wouldn't have no excuse to die for our sin. And then Jesus said, when I go away, I'm going to send you the Holy Ghost, which is power. He will lead you and guide you.
Yes,
so the Holy
yes.
Ghost is down here working in our behalf.
Amen.
And he will keep us if we succumb to the Holy Ghost.
Yes,
to the Holy
right.
Spirit. And the Holy Spirit, you can't see it, but you can feel it.
Yes. Yes.
Right, right.
That's right.
I can't see it, but I feel it.
Amen.
And I ain't nuts either. That means when you talk about you feel it. Yeah, I feel it.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
I feel better than what you feel.
Right.
Amen.
You feel your secret set? That's a spirit.
Oh, it's quiet.
Oh,
man.
Y'all, you know what secret seven is, don't you? That's sequin. Y'all better pray for me.
You all right. Come on.
You knew where I was coming from. Eventually.
Amen. Amen.
Secret seven. That's a spirit.
Yes, it is.
Yes, sir.
That's a spirit got you drinking like that.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, it is.
You know, hey, don't you know when you get overtaken with that spirit and you do something wrong, then what do? They put you in jail.
Yes.
So when you tell them, man, I'm high, that's one of the reasons why I did that. They say, well, you know, wear it off in jail.
Right.
You still have to be punished.
Yeah.
Come on now.
Amen.
Come on now.
Amen.
Everybody know act a fool when they get high.
All right.
Amen.
Because they know how to control it. Mm-hmm. But there are some that get into it that they don't know how to control it.
Mm-hmm. Right.
But I say don't take it at all. The Bible talks about strong drinks. Strong drinks don't drink.
Right.
Amen.
Come on now.
Amen.
When Jesus drank wine, it was pure wine.
Right.
It wasn't that wine to make you.
Right.
Nobody.
Amen.
Pure.
Mm-hmm.
It was pure.
Yeah.
Even at the at the wedding.
Mm-hmm.
They said the best wine was served,
right.
But that wine was made out of water.
Mm-hmm.
See the power of God.
Amen.
They said when they had all of them had the wine that was there first and the further then he said we ran out and Jesus' mother told him go get some more. Took a barrel of water, changed it to God worked the miracle and changed it to wine, and they said it was the best wine.
Amen.
Yeah.
It was something about drinking the Spirit of God.
Right.
Not going to the gross liquor store now.
Right.
I ain't telling you to go to the liquor store. Don't
Amen.
Uh-uh. Stay out of there.
Amen.
Right. Come on.
Come on now. And sometimes people think I can handle it. I can handle that. I can handle that. I can handle anything.
No, no.
One day
no.
You ain't gonna be able to handle it.
Come on.
I know that's right.
You ain't gonna be able to handle it, you're gonna be dead.
I know that's right.
I'm warning you now, you're gonna be dead.
Amen.
Don't do it. Stay out of that liquor store.
Amen.
Stay away from folks that's drinking and all that sort of
right.
stuff. And you acting a fool.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes.
Come on,
go ahead.
I think I'm warning somebody.
Oh, oh yes. Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
And then the people, then your family's crying and all that sort of stuff because you were hard headed.
Right.
And wouldn't obey.
Amen.
Amen.
Man, leave me alone. I can do what I want to do. I'm grown. Yeah, you're going to be grown and dead.
Yep.
I'm warning you.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
You're going to be grown and dead.
Right. Come on.
Well, you know, I know how to handle it, see. I know how to handle it. I know when to stop. But that will get you to a place where you don't know when to stop.
Right,
you know,
sir.
That's true. That is so true.
And you want to keep on taking it.
Come on.
I'm going God where God got me going.
Go ahead.
That's what happens.
You keep on taking. Keep on taking. I had a friend that died that was snorting cocaine. And he was overseas. And we got the news that somebody we knew overdosed, sniffing. We were sitting there, we were going, man. And he was raised in church. He was raised in church just like I was raised in church. He knew better just like I knew better. But he got out there and got all mixed up with the world and got hooked on all that stuff. You know, and people were offering that stuff. Somebody offered me the reefer before I even tried. They even said, man, have you ever had some of this weed, man? And I'm going, what is weed? Yeah, I was that stupid. But the devil will send you somebody to hook you up. And he'll hook you up for your downfall.
Right.
Right.
I got to say this.
Yeah.
Hook you up for your downfall.
Right.
Set you up. The devil's setting you up. Right now, he's setting somebody up.
Yes.
Amen.
It ain't funny.
Amen.
Dying without Christ ain't funny.
No, it's not.
Amen.
It's not something that you should take lightly.
That's not right. At all.
Well, you know, if I die, I just die. It's just more to it than just if you die. You just die.
Yes, it is. Amen.
Do you really believe that? That if you just die, you just die? And then you got to leave your loved ones back here crying over you because you were stupid.
Right. Right.
Didn't listen. Won't listen. Think because you're grown and who you are, can't nobody tell me nothing. Right.
Amen.
But when you get into the lake of fire, the burning, somebody gonna tell you something. Then you be ready to listen.
Amen.
I'm talking to somebody. I'm talking to somebody.
Yes, Lord.
Come on.
God, tired of you acting like a fool. Acting foolish. Won't listen to nobody. Just as stubborn as a rock.
Amen.
Don't you know your sins will find you out?
Oh, yeah.
Amen.
Yes, sir. Amen.
And then all of us that are in church that know that person will be sort of, what? He did what? And what? Surprise. Because we didn't know that person was like that. Sometimes the family be trying to tell you, I told you he needed help. You needed, she needed help. You know, I didn't know it got that far.
Yeah.
You don't have control over your life.
No.
Yeah.
I've got control over this. I've got control over this. You ain't got control over nothing.
Amen.
Only what God allowed you to do.
Right,
and
right.
He's doing it under his mercy.
That's right.
Amen. Amen.
You think you got control?
Amen.
You ain't got no control over what you think you got control over.
Amen.
It's just God's mercy that you haven't gotten
right.
Further beyond where you got already.
Right.
And he's just having mercy on you,
yes.
Kindness on
yes.
You.
Jesus. Yes.
But God's spirit will not always strive with man. While God is striving with you right now and talking to you right now, he's giving you the opportunity to say, Lord, change me.
Yes.
Amen. I ain't trying to play with your soul. This ain't no fairy tale.
Amen.
This is real.
Amen.
How many know it's real? I heard it from the housetop.
Yes,
God will have you going somewhere because he wants to save you.
Right.
He wants to keep
that's
you.
It.
Man. He wants to hold on to you.
Yes.
But do you want to hold on to him?
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
God, I'm tired of folks getting angry and mad and then take it out on y'all better hear me, God. Getting angry and mad and you take your frustration out on people and on God.
Right.
Like he did it to you.
Right. Amen.
Something you did it to yourself.
Amen.
Something you can't even blame on other folks. I don't care what they did. That don't make me drink.
Right.
Amen. Oh,
no choice. Amen.
Oh.
My God. Help me.
I told you I wanted somebody. Nobody called me. Nobody said nothing. I hear it. God's warning you.
Man.
Keep it up. You ain't gonna live long.
Man.
So Tashib, I hear that. Now, I'm not talking
say
to you,
it,
but I'm just
say
saying.
It.
I'm hearing it.
Amen. Say it. We need it. We all need it.
You think because God let you get by this week, next week, you got it made.
Amen.
Come on.
You ain't got it made.
Come on.
Because when they say, the Bible said, when they say peace and safety,
yes.
When they say I'm all
yes.
Right,
yes.
The Bible said, then come what? Sudden what? Destruction.
Yes.
After a while, the devil will bounce on you. Next thing you know, did you hear?
Come on.
Larry died.
Mm-hmm.
You Judy died. Go on Facebook.
Come on.
How many funerals are they putting out there on Facebook?
Every day.
Every day somebody died.
Yes.
I don't want to die without God.
No.
I don't mind dying as long as I stay saved. All he's trying to do is scare me. If that's going to scare you to get saved,
okay,
I'm going to scare you.
Amen. Right.
Man. I've heard our apostles say many times to people, say, you know what? You keep that up, you're going to be dead.
Mm-hmm.
And sure enough, he was a true prophet.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
They died. I've heard people get up and say, God told me that if I leave him one more time, I'm not coming back to him. Did we hear that, man?
Amen.
Stood up and testified. This is after she got saved. She said, God said, "Don't. This is it. One more time. You ain't getting back." Somehow or another, she let somebody. She right back out there in the world. Had an accident. Somebody else was driving. The person that was driving only got their leg broke. She was in the back and was killed instantly. That's sad.
Yes, it is.
That's sad after being warned, yeah. And then you still gonna overlook it? Mm. That's dying. That's what? That's a foolish death.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
And the devil will have you forgetting.
Amen.
Yeah. He don't want you to think about that. Oh man, come on. That's just, you know, that's, you know how the preachers are. They, you know, they just be, you know, they right. just try to get folks saved.
What
and then they start laughing and making fun. You know, he just trying to get, what's wrong with that?
Right.
What's trying to get, what's wrong with trying to get you saved to stay saved?
Right.
So you can go to heaven with him.
Right. Amen. That's it.
I bet you he's just as bad as we are. You don't know me.
Right. Come on.
And I don't know you.
Come on.
But I hear what God is saying.
Amen.
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 Think about it. Examine yourself. Some of you already know how you are.
Amen.
In God. You can fool some of the people, but you can't fool God.
Amen.
Amen.
Are we still talking about holiness?
Oh, yes. Yes.
Oh, yes.
We still talking about holiness. I'm trying to prepare you for holiness, trying to prepare you for heaven. And the only way you're going to get to heaven is to be holy.
Amen.
Sanctified.
Right.
Under the cloud.
Right.
Giving up all your sin. Man,
that's
I should give this up, man, because that baby had it going on, man. I'm telling you, see? I have seen, and I ain't going to say I've seen, I have heard two people say they're going to come to God after they get married. And this is through a testimony that an apostle gave. Said they were saying, I'll get married later.
Hmm.
Both of them had an accident. Both of them died instantly.
Mm-hmm.
Where do you think you're going to go with your marriage? You don't have your life in control? Who breathed that breath in your body that you gave with your soul?
Amen.
Just like he gave it to you, he can take it.
Amen.
You don't have to believe me, heck.
It's true.
I believe what I'm saying.
Amen.
Because of the word.
Right.
You can believe
That's
what
it.
You want. You
That's
can,
it.
Yeah, you can ignore it. Well, don't say I didn't tell you.
Mm-hmm.
But you know what? Some people, you know, God's going to have to rehearse it over your head as you die.
Amen.
And that's going to be bad.
Amen.
Then you're going to want help. And the Bible said, because you didn't regard my what? Correction.
Mm-hmm.
My reproof.
Right.
He said, when your calamity comes, mm-hmm. when your trouble comes, when your, let me just say that, when your problems come,
mm-hmm.
what do you say? I'll mock you.
Mm-hmm.
God will make fun of you.
Yes, yes.
You know why? Because you make light of God.
Right.
You made fun of God.
Amen.
You made light of what he was saying. You made light of what the preacher was saying. So you didn't take it into your heart. So now you want God while you on your sick bed to heal you.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
And the Bible said he will laugh at your calamity.
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
That's Bible.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes,
amen.
Get that from me, minister.
Yes, it is.
Say it. Amen.
Proverbs, first chapter.
Yeah. Let my reader get that. Proverbs. He will laugh. Was that Proverbs what?
First.
He will laugh at your calamity.
Amen.
126.
126. I want you to get it. It's in the Bible.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
I ain't telling you something that I made up. Even though sometimes people be saying, well, you know, man wrote that. Yeah, as it was moved by the Holy Ghost.
Right. Right.
Yes.
Brought it unto himself. You can't blame God.
Right.
Blame yourself.
Right. Amen.
When you're on your deathbed, blame yourself.
Amen.
Don't blame everybody. They want to blame everybody if right. they had to do this and they had to do right. that. They didn't right. have to do. You have to give an account of your own
you
life.
Right, sir.
Right. That's right.
I don't care if your husband is acting a fool. Yeah. You stay safe.
Yeah.
I don't care if your wife is acting a fool. Yeah. You stay
yeah.
safe.
Yeah. Yeah. Amen.
Right. You ain't got to go to hell because he's going to hell.
Right.
And vice versa.
Yeah. Amen.
Some people you just got to leave alone because you've been trying to tell them for years.
Yes.
So you just don't say nothing to them.
Thank God.
Right.
You let God because see some fussing at it sometimes. Ain't going to change.
Right. Amen.
Right.
Talk about it.
Sometimes fussing every time they and they so concerned about you because they love you.
Right.
You don't even love yourself.
Right. Come on.
I'm fussing at somebody.
Amen.
Amen.
You don't even love yourself. I haven't brought a message that do you love yourself?
Right.
God. You know why I'm going this way.
Amen. Amen.
Come on up, come on up, Dennis. You can come on up here and read that. Get a little emotional in that, y'all.
Amen.
Because when it comes right. down to a soul, I'm concerned.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Some people don't realize how real this is.
Amen.
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 I don't know nothing about your household.
Nope.
I don't know nothing about your life.
Amen.
Nobody called me up.
Nope.
And what I hear from the housetop. You won't have to go to bed or die.
Amen.
Amen.
I'm tired. It's getting tired. Go ahead, beautiful.
Amen. Proverbs 1:24. Because I have called and ye refused, I have stretched out my hand and no man regarded. But ye have set at naught all my counsel and would none of my reproof.
Would not even try to let God reprove you, correct you. Read that first verse again. Take your tag because I want to say something between that. Yeah.
All right. Because I have called.
Before I called, don't you know God is calling you right now?
Yes.
Man.
All of us in here, God is calling us. Yes. Even though we're saved, he's still calling us to come up higher.
Yes. Right.
In holiness and righteousness.
Yes. Yes.
And it's up to us to take heed to that call.
Amen.
It ain't just to the sinners, it's to all of us.
Yes. Right. Yes.
Take heed.
Amen. Take heed.
Yes.
Give in to it.
Yes. Yes.
Take heed.
That's it. That's it.
Come on.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Read it.
Because I have called and ye refuse.
You refuse.
I have stretched out my hand.
Look, this is what God is doing now.
Amen. Right now. Amen.
He's warning you now. He got his hand stretched out.
Amen.
What you gonna do about it?
Amen.
Go ahead.
And no man regarded.
And no man. Don't you know God is still stretching out his hands all day long?
Yes.
Thank you, Lord.
And men still stubborn and hard-headed. Women too.
Yeah.
And children rebellious.
Yes.
A rebellious generation. This
yes.
Yes,
a
is.
Rebellious generation.
Yes.
But you don't have to fall in that category.
Amen. Amen.
Go ahead.
But ye have set at naught all my counsel.
You have set at naught. In other words, you didn't. Yeah, well, you know, he said it. Mm-hmm. It don't mean nothing.
Right.
It don't mean nothing to me because I'm going to do my thing, you know. Hey. Yeah, but you're gonna reap the consequences of it.
Amen.
Go ahead.
And with none of my reproof.
Doesn't even want to take what I'm trying to correct you.
Mm-hmm.
The preacher, this is all what the preacher is trying to do right now
Amen.
Is correct you and change so he right. so you can live and not die.
Right.
To
right.
declare the works of the Lord.
Yes.
Amen.
So that you might live.
Yes.
How merciful is that?
Amen.
To warn you.
Yes.
I think a person is foolish if somebody told you, You know what, man? They looking for you down here. Mm-hmm. It's about three of them. Mm-hmm. And they got a pistol. Oh, man, stop joking. Mm-hmm. And you go down there and right. you finally find out.
Right.
After you got put in the hospital that they were right. Mm-hmm. Why you gotta wait right. until right. something happened yeah. to believe?
Right.
Amen. Exactly.
Amen.
Amen.
Come on now.
You gotta show me first. I can show you, but you don't have to live through it.
Come on now.
That don't mean you're going to live through it.
That's right.
I ain't looking at nobody. I'm just looking at everybody.
Amen. Amen.
This is going for me too.
Amen.
Go ahead, man.
I also will laugh at your calamity.
That's Bible.
God
said it. I didn't say that. He said, I will, that's what he was telling Israel. I will laugh at your calamity.
Right.
He, when they wanted God, after they got in trouble, the enemy started, you know, overtaking them, then they wanted God.
Amen. Amen.
And they wanted God to move right away.
Right.
God said, no, it ain't that easy.
Okay.
Sometimes God do things right away. Mm-hmm. Just to show you. Mm-hmm. I'm having mercy.
Amen.
But everybody don't do that.
Amen.
Don't be one of those that he don't do that to.
Amen.
Have mercy.
Come on, man.
Because none of us look that good.
Okay. I'm not sure.
Okay. We look good, but we don't look that good. We ain't that pretty.
Amen.
We ain't that handsome.
Amen. That's right.
Amen.
I don't care if you got a name for yourself.
Okay.
That name ain't gonna get you out of hell.
No, it's not.
It ain't gonna keep you from dying. There's some missiles in the grave.
Yes.
Amen.
They money couldn't even get them out of the grave.
Come on.
But they money, only the only thing they gave them was a rich funeral.
Right. Mm-hmm. Right.
Amen.
Amen.
Come on, man, just stop.
I also will laugh at your calamity.
He will laugh. God will literally laugh at your calamity.
Yeah. I will mock when your fear cometh.
When you say, oh, Lord, he'll mock you. Yeah. Oh, Lord. Mm-hmm. Help me, Jesus. Help me, Jesus. You can't hear him, but he's mocking you.
Okay.
What if you really heard it? The Bible says he will mock you
Amen.
While you were in your trouble. And mock means also he will not answer you.
Yeah. Mm.
That's mocking you.
That's okay. Right. Okay.
Not answering you. Right. Oh, Lord, he ain't answering you. He hear you, but he ain't answering you. He's mocking you. Uh-huh.
When your fear cometh as desolation.
Then here come your fear.
And your destruction cometh as a whirlwind.
As a what?
As a whirlwind.
Yeah.
When distress and anguish cometh upon you.
Look at that.
Then shall they call upon me, but I will not answer.
Did y'all hear that?
Amen.
You will mock you. You won't answer. Why ain't God hearing me? Why didn't you hear him?
Right.
Amen. Right.
Why didn't you hear us?
Amen.
Why didn't you hear the preacher?
Amen.
Why didn't you listen to those who was trying to tell you what you need to do?
Right.
Why?
Come on. Amen.
It goes both ways.
Amen. Yes, it does.
I'm trying to help somebody, Sister T.
Amen. Yes.
I don't know what is in here or out here. Out there.
Amen.
Don't die as a fool dies.
Yes.
You know why I said don't die as a fool? Because right now you hear me.
Amen.
Right. And if you don't obey it, that's a fool.
Yes.
You won't listen to wisdom.
Yeah.
Right. You listen to God's word, that's a fool.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
Not regarding what? Reproof.
Yes, amen.
Go ahead.
They shall seek me early.
Seek me early.
But they shall not find me.
When they get to the big beginning of something.
Yes.
Man, I just found out I got cancer. Now you know God.
Right.
And they told me I'm in, what is the worst state?
Four.
Stage four. Mm-hmm. Now you know God. God had told me it was in stage four. Well, what was you doing when you was okay?
Right. Amen.
You didn't act like you wanted God that bad when you was walking okay, running around, doing all your nasty stuff.
Okay.
Come on down.
Okay.
I'm talking to somebody.
Amen. Come right.
On. Go ahead.
For that they hated knowledge and did not show. choose the fear of the Lord.
Oh, they hated knowledge. They rejected knowledge. That's yes. all we be trying to do Amen. Is give you knowledge. Let right. you know you Amen. Stay in your sins.
Yes.
You're going to die.
Amen.
A fool's death.
Yes.
Amen.
I told you I heard it. And then you know what sometimes happens, evangelists? Sometimes we have a funeral for somebody we thought was saved. Mm. Try to have a Christian funeral. And they ain't never dying worth of nothing.
Right.
God didn't accept that.
No, it's not. No, it's not.
And then the loved ones saying, we putting them in heaven. They gone to heaven. And the family is saying, Pastor just don't know.
Amen.
You don't know like I know. Mm. I don't want to know your business. God knows your business.
Amen.
Go ahead, baby.
They would none of my counsel.
They would not. Come on, my God, I'm trying to counsel. God is trying to counsel you now.
Amen.
He's trying to talk to you now. He's trying to talk to us now.
Yes.
What's wrong with you? Go ahead.
They despised all my reproof.
They hate it. They don't like it.
Mm-hmm.
They don't receive it. They hate all my what?
All my reproof.
All everything I try to tell them to do to warn them.
Mm-hmm.
They don't see it. God just don't know. What you mean God just don't know? God just don't know how I feel. Yeah, he know how you feel.
Yes, he
does.
Yes.
That's why he's talking to you. Because
yes.
he know how you feel.
Yes.
And what you feeling is wrong.
Amen.
What you doing is wrong.
Yes.
God knows the desire of your heart. He knows the intents of your thoughts. He knows your heart, your
Amen.
Thoughts. You know what you're going to do before you do it.
That's right.
Amen.
Because he's God.
Yes.
You might not
That's
believe
right.
that, but he know.
That's
he
right.
know.
Oh, yes.
You know what you're going to do tomorrow before you do it. I might
yes,
not know.
Does.
But he know.
He knows.
Amen.
And sometimes he be trying to keep you out of harm's way.
Right.
But you stubborn, you want to do it anyway. No, I'm good by myself. I'm 21 plus. 55 and more. They got all kinds of ages out there in the grave.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I'm not saying something. I'm saying something that's real.
Amen.
Think about it. Go home and think about it. Matter of fact, think about it now.
Amen.
Right. Don't wait till you get home. Think about it now.
Yes. Amen.
If I would die right now, where am I going?
Right. Right. Amen.
According to the Bible, where am I going?
Amen.
Amen.
Think about it. So the brother of God ain't gonna keep talking to us.
No. Amen.
He ain't gonna keep warning us.
No. Amen.
He ain't gonna keep doing it. He ain't gonna keep doing it.
Amen.
God be opening up doors and allowing you to do something and just to show you he's still on you. Mm-hmm. What about returning that?
Right.
Amen. That love towards God. He said, if you love me, you what? You will keep my commandments.
Amen.
You will do it what I say.
Yeah.
Right.
Amen.
Ain't that Bible?
Yes.
Amen.
See, you don't get saved to get out of trouble.
Amen.
And then after things seem like it's cool, you go back into the same old pernicious way.
No.
You done took advantage of God's mercy.
Yes.
To the point
Amen.
Where in you.
Come on.
Amen.
Come on.
God know what you're doing.
Yes.
Amen.
So you can get out of harm's way.
Yes.
But it ain't over till God says over.
Amen.
Go ahead.
Therefore shall they eat of the fruit of their own way and be filled with their own devices.
You hear what that said? You can read that again.
Therefore shall they eat of the fruit of their own way.
You don't have to eat of the fruit of your own way. You sin, you're going to have to bear it.
Yes, amen. Amen.
Yourself. Amen.
You're destroying yourself.
Amen.
What is that saying? Made your bed, you got a life.
Right.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
You made it. You made that bed.
Mm-hmm.
Now you got to lay in it. Mm-hmm. Now you want God to get you out of it.
Amen.
Man, that's mean. For you to turn God down is mean.
Right.
Amen.
Right.
What was so
Amen.
Good about that? What
right.
was so good about
that? Say that now.
About turning God down.
Amen.
Amen.
Come on.
Not regarding his reproof.
Right.
Amen. Bring it to naught all his counsels.
Come on.
What's good about that?
Right.
I told y'all, if your children disobeyed, you almost knocked them into Arkansas.
Uh-huh.
Why didn't you have mercy? Boy, just like I brought you in this world, I can take you out. That's what you threatened with, right? Well, God is using his word to let you know.
Same
you don't
way.
Hear, you don't listen,
okay.
I'm going to mock you when your calamity comes.
Yes.
I shall laugh at you, let you know.
Okay.
I brought you here,
okay.
I can take you out.
Oh,
you can.
That's true.
He's God.
Amen.
Men can take you, men can try to take you out, but if God ain't ready for you to go, you ain't going.
Right.
Amen.
I said, if God is not ready for you to go, I don't care what people do, amen, you going to stay.
Amen.
Because God got something
That's right.
in plan.
Right.
But once he gets tired,
amen.
The hands of mercy is gone. I'm still talking about holiness.
Holiness. Amen.
I'm almost through.
Man.
Read it, Amanda.
For the turning away of the simple shall slay them.
The turning away of the simple shall slay them.
And the prosperity of fools shall destroy them.
You hear that? Did it say fools in here?
Yes, it did.
Being with the simple minded and prosperity will cause you harm.
Fools, amen.
God said, the Bible
yes,
said, you're
yes.
a fool.
Right.
You're foolish. All of us at one time were foolish.
Amen.
Y'all know, right?
Amen.
Like
right.
I said, we wasn't saved all our life.
Amen.
And we knew holiness. We were amen. Raised in holiness. I was raised in holiness ever since I was 5 years old.
Amen. Amen.
Got up. Looked out there at the world, tasted of the world, and got busy. But God was merciful.
Amen.
And you know why God
oh,
had
God.
Mercy on
Thank
me?
You, Lord Jesus.
Because he knew later on, I'm going to use that brother
Amen.
For the work of the ministry. God said, that to me when I was real young, that I was going to be called to the ministry. God has a work for everybody. We was talking about that.
Amen.
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 Yes, sir.
Amen.
He got a work for you, but if you turn him away, he ain't going to make you do nothing.
Nope.
Amen.
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 Some of y'all got good talents.
Amen.
Good things that God can use you for.
Yes.
And you throwing it away.
Amen.
Throwing it away. For what? Well, you can give it to God. And let him bless your soul.
Amen.
Amen.
Let you be increased. You know what? I wake up every morning thanking God.
Amen.
I do. I wake up every morning saying, God, I thank you for waking me up this morning.
Yes.
It's a blessing to be able to get up. Even though I know I'm going to heaven, I still it's a blessing to get up. Now, why thank God for blessing you to get up and you're going to get up to sing?
Right. Amen.
He didn't get you up so you can sing.
Right. Right.
Amen.
Come on.
So you can do wrong.
Right.
God can help you with your can't help it.
Yes,
he can. Yes, he can. Yes. He knows you can't do it on your own. Right. He can help you with your can't help it.
Yes.
But you have to walk with the strong.
Yes.
Not with the weak. No geese hanging with the crows.
Right.
They all go their separate way.
Right.
I've seen it in the sky. Crows be going that way and the geese going that way.
Amen.
And they don't be running into each other. They were saying, my bad.
Amen.
If animals know how to separate themselves, then you got more intelligence than animals. They know how to separate, man. I'm a duck. So what I'm going to hang around with a crocodile for? That ain't my family.
That's right.
You holy. You supposed to be with your holy family. You supposed to be with your holy family. Not with the sinners.
Amen.
I told y'all y'all got to
do it.
Yes, sir.
Oh, amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, bless you.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
All right.
Come on now.
You better hear. Scripture says, today, if you will hear his voice, harden not your heart.
Yes, Lord.
Don't allow your heart to become hard towards God.
Yes, come on.
Telling you, I do not want to have, and I'm not saying it's going to happen here, but anyway, as ministers and preachers, we don't want to have a foolish funeral.
Amen. Amen.
Do y'all hear what I'm saying?
Amen. Amen.
That's why Pastor Willis and Bishop Willis and all those that are saved is pressing on, because we know life is not promised to us.
Amen.
And we realize we can't get past God. I don't care what nobody says. Don't nobody own me. God does.
Yeah. Yes, he does.
Come on.
You his creation. Creation.
Yes.
He own you by creation.
Yes.
Not
yes.
by salvation, but by creation.
Right.
He's the reason why you here.
Yes.
Amen.
He formed man in the what? In the earth, in the dust of the earth, and breathed into his nostril, and he became a living soul. He did. We did not come from apes and beasts.
No, we didn't.
How did they get here?
Right. Right.
Come on.
Amen.
Amen.
Did you think about that?
Right.
Man evolved. Scientists always want you to not believe God.
Amen.
It ain't scientifically.
No.
It's the Bible way.
Amen. Right. Yes, it is.
God's way. Amen.
God's way. I done did, Lord. I done did for what I had.
Man.
I'm still, I didn't get a chance to go into the scriptures.
It's all right. It's all right.
I know.
Don't die of food, Dad. When you leave here, when you turn that phone on, when you get out of Facebook, don't let it just water on the duck's back.
Right. Take heed.
Take heed.
Amen.
Take heed to how you what? Hear.
Right. Right.
Well, you know, I heard. You ain't doing God a favor.
Right. Come on.
Excuse
Amen.
Me.
Amen.
Come on.
You think you're doing God a favor? No, you're doing yourself a favor.
Amen. Amen.
Everything that God does for us, if we obey, we're doing ourselves a favor.
Right.
And God said, no, I want you to go this way, because now is the time for somebody to
hear this. Right.
Yes.
Believe it or not, everybody in here is here for a purpose.
Amen. Yeah.
You didn't come in here by accident.
All right.
Right, sir. Amen.
Amen. It was a reason why.
Yes.
Those of you that stay safe, stay safe.
Amen.
Because he's warning us too.
Yes.
Stay safe. That's now.
Right.
Amen.
You got to stay safe.
That's right.
You got to keep on fighting the good fight of faith.
Yes.
Man, hold to eternal life.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Man.
That man is something else. No, that's God.
Amen.
I take no credit for what I
said. Amen.
Let us pray. Oh, gracious Father, we thank you today for your word.
Thank you, God.
For your counseling.
Yes,
Lord. Oh, God, we ask you, oh, God, those that are among us, oh, God, and those that are listening to us on Facebook and YouTube, oh, God,
yes,
or wherever they might be listening to this tape, oh, God. We ask you that you touch their hearts, God. Touch their mind. You were warning somebody. Warning them, oh God, to turn from their foolish ways that they might live and not die. Right now, God, we ask you that you come into their heart and into their minds, oh God. Oh God, you can make that stony heart, oh God, a heart of flesh, oh God. In the name of Jesus, that they might be able to serve you in the beauty of holiness, oh God. And we ask you that you lay your hands on them right now, God. In the name of Jesus, oh God. There's nothing too hard for you, oh God. You still saving. You still delivering. Your arms are still stretched out all day long to those that will call on you, God. And ask, oh God, for repentance, oh God. Ask for deliverance, oh God. Ask for salvation, oh God. Ask them for holiness. Even if they don't know what it all means. But God, I want that.
Yes, Lord.
I want to get into it. I want to see what it's all about.
Yes.
Because I don't want my life to be all jacked up and messed up, oh God. In the name of Jesus. Touch that mind, God. Regulate that mind, oh God. In the name of Jesus. And, oh God, you're not going to make it. You're not going to force it. Because you said in your word, whosoever will, let him come. Let her come. In their own will. They can do it, God.
Yes.
If you saved us, what you did, you can save them.
Yes.
And you won't hold it against them no more, God. All they have to do is say, God, come into my heart. Come into my mind. Deliver me, oh God. I want that salvation that preacher was preaching about. I don't want to die and go to hell. I don't want to leave here before my time. Before my time, when I can live longer. But because of my hard headedness, because of my rebelliousness, oh God, amen, my life will be short.
Yes,
save me, God.
Save me, Lord.
That's what you need to say. Save
yes,
me, God.
Save.
Wash me, God.
Yes,
cleanse me,
yes,
God.
Yes,
come into my life, oh God.
Yes,
oh God, lead me and guide me, oh God.
Yes,
send me to a place that's going to teach me, oh God, and guide me.
Yes.
In the truth, oh God, and not concerned, oh God, about the membership, but concerned
yes.
about my soul.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
Concerned.
Holy.
Concerned.
Yes, Lord. Yes,
about
God.
My soul.
Yes, God.
Bless me, God.
Yes, God.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, God.
Right now.
Right now, Lord.
From the crown of their head.
Yes.
Lord, to the sole of their feet.
Yes, God.
Right now, God, I'm willing to change. I'm willing to change. I'm willing to walk the path of holiness and sanctification. I don't know all about it, oh God, but I'm willing to learn.
Yes,
Lord. Learn. Teach me, God. Teach me.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
That I might be your son.
Yes, God.
And that you might be my father.
Yes,
Jesus.
My eternal father. Come on into my life.
Yes, yes.
Right now.
Right now.
Right now.
Right now.
God is working miracles right now.
Yes, he is. Yes, he is.
Being saved is a miracle.
Yes.
Stop the design of the world right now.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Help me what my can't help is
yes,
right now.
Yes,
help me to put it away, God.
Yes, Lord.
Look like I'm always drawn unto this thing. Look like every time I turn around, I'm drawn to it. I'm overtaken by it, oh God. But I'm willing to give it up. To fight the good fight of faith, oh God. To live this life so that I can live. Again and not die. Save God. Save God.
Save
God.
Save
me, God.
Save
me, God.
Save
me, God.
Cleanse
me, God. Wash me, God. Deliver me, God. Right now, God.
Right
into my seat. Give me your Sunday. Your Sunday. Save.
Save.
Deliver.
Yes.
Yes, Lord.
Set free.
Yes, Lord.
That open heart.
Yes, Lord.
That open mind.
Yes, Lord.
Jesus.
And he would do it.
Thank you, God. Hallelujah.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Give God a victory.